Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino project video. Today we are going to build an Arduino game, a Tic Tac Toe game with a touchscreen. It is an easy and fun project for all ages. Let's start! Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular boards. In this video, we are going to build an Arduino tic-tac-toe game. As you can see, we are using a touchscreen and we are playing against the computer. A simple game like Tic Tac Toe is a great introduction to game programming and artificial intelligence. Even though we won't be using any artificial intelligence algorithms in this game, we will understand why artificial intelligence algorithms are required in more complex games. I really like games and I love developing games. For the last 5 years I work as a game developer and I have developed many Android games. My most popular one is named Quiz of Knowledge and it is a free quiz game which offers thousands of multiple choice questions in 6 languages. If you enjoy quiz games, you can find a link for it and for my other games in the description of the video below. Developing games for Android is much easier than developing games for Arduino, but we can build some simple games for Arduino because it is fun and it will allow us to explore some more advanced programming topics like artificial intelligence. Let's now build this project. The parts needed in order to build this project are the following: an Arduino Uno and a 2.8-inch touchscreen. The cost of the project is around $15. You can find links for the parts we use in the description of the video. Before attempting to build this project, please watch the video I have prepared about the touch display by clicking on the card here. It will help you understand the code and calibrate the touch screen. After connecting the screen to the Arduino Uno, we can load the code and we are ready to play. At first, we press the Start Game button and the game starts. The Arduino plays first. We can then play our move simply by touching the screen. The Arduino then plays its move and so on. The player who succeeds in placing 3 of their marks in a horizontal, vertical or diagonal row wins the game. When the game is over, the game over screen appears. We can then press the Play Again button to start the game again. The Arduino is very good at this game. It will win most of the games, or if you are a very good player, the game will end in a draw. I intentionally designed this algorithm to make some mistakes in order to give the human player a chance to win. By adding 2 more lines to the code of the game, we can make the Arduino impossible to lose the game. But how can a $2 chip, the Arduino CPU, beat the human brain? Is the program we developed smarter than the human brain? In order to answer this question, let's look at the algorithm I have implemented. The computer always plays first. This decision alone makes the game much easier for the Arduino to win. The first move is always a corner. The second move for the Arduino is also a random corner from the remaining ones, without caring about the player move at all. From this point on, the Arduino first checks if the player can win in the next move and blocks that move. If the player can't win in a single move, it plays a corner move if it is available, or a random one from the remaining. That's it! This simple algorithm can beat the human player every time, or at the worst case scenario, the game will result in a draw. This is not the best tic-tac-toe game algorithm, but one of the simplest. This algorithm can be implemented in Arduino easily because the tic-tac-toe game is very simple and we can easily analyze it and solve it. If we design the game tree, we can discover some winning strategies and easily implement them in code, or we can let the CPU compute the game tree in real time and choose the best move by itself. Of course, the algorithm we use in this game is very simple because the game is very simple. If we try to design a winning algorithm for chess, even if we use the fastest computer, we can't compute the game tree in 1000 years. For games like this, we need another approach. We need some artificial intelligence algorithms and, of course, huge processing power. More on this on a future video. let's take a quick look at the code of the project. We need three libraries in order the code to compile. You can find links for all the libraries in the description below. As you can see, even a simple game like this requires more than 600 lines of code. The code is complex, so I won't try to explain it in a 5-minute video. I'll show you the implementation of the algorithm for the Arduino moves though. At first, we play two random corners. Next, in each round, we check if the player can win the game in the next move. If yes, we block that move most of the times. We don't block all the moves in order to give the human player a chance to win. Can you find which moves are not blocked? After blocking the move, we play a remaining corner or a random move. You can study the code and implement your own unbeatable algorithm easily. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video below. As you can see, even with an Arduino Uno, we can build an unbeatable algorithm for simple games. This project is great because it is easy to build and at the same time, it is a great introduction to artificial intelligence and game programming. I will try to build some more advanced projects with artificial intelligence in the future using the more powerful Raspberry Pi, so stay tuned. I would love to hear your opinion about this project. Please post your comments below and don't forget to like the video if you find it interesting. Thanks! If you are new to the channel, I would love to have you subscribed by clicking on the channel icon here, because every Saturday I post a new video about do-it-yourself electronics and robot projects. I hope you will join our community. See you next week!